And welcome to another episode of Strategy in 10 Minutes with Fran from Underwing. This is a little series where we give little hints and tips about business and marketing strategy. As I said in all of my videos prior to this one, this is in no way a substitute for proper business strategy sessions, but just hints and tips for those of you who feel very adventurous and want to try doing their own strategies by themselves, or just are starting a business and need some hints and tips on how to start and how to bring your business forward. Now, this episode, as promised in the last video where we talked about how to run a business when you have special educational needs, is all going to be about identifying your ideal client. We all run businesses, we either sell products or services, and for each one of those products and services, we might have one or more ideal clients. So, not every product or service will appeal to everyone. Not even Coca-Cola does, not even Nike shoes do. Some people won't buy into the ethos, some people won't just like it. Some people are gonna be already really loyal clients to someone else. So you have to identify the type of audience which will be a better match for your products or services. So why is this important to find the ideal clients and reach them? Because first of all, if you're trying to sell something to someone who doesn't need it or doesn't want it, it's going to be a very difficult sale. And second, it's so much easier to have people coming to you instead of running after them, trying to give them something they don't want or they don't need. Once you put your products or services in front of the right audience, you won't need to sell. They will come to you because they want what you have, they want what you're offering, because they need it, because it's solving them a problem, because it's something they were looking for. So in order to identify who is your ideal client, you want to think about a couple of things. One is, what problem does your product or service solve? Everyone has got what we call problems, and we use every day products and services to solve them. If we have stinky feet, we're gonna buy a cream that helps us, but also wash our feet. If we are thirsty, we're going to buy something that is going to help, or we're gonna drink some water. But if we're out, we're gonna have a Diet Coke or an orange juice, or we're gonna have whatever else quenches our thirst. If we are looking for someone to design our website, we're gonna look for a website designer who also can understand our brand and put it in a website that's gonna be appealing for everyone. So how do we look for that? We look for that online, we look for that by word of mouth, we look for that offline on the high street. So we look around when we're looking for a product or a service. And this is the reason why it is really important for you to not only be around, but to be in the right place where your ideal client can see you. So to identify your ideal client, we want to look at, what pain are you solving? What problem are you solving? What are the people looking for? People who are looking for a product like yours or a service like yours. It's obvious they are looking for that product or service, but what are they looking for in depth? So if I am selling a course that helps people being visible online, the people who are looking for my services are looking for establishing their online presence, being different from the competition, standing out in some way, finding content that attracts people, So break down your products and services and know what do the people who will buy it want? What kind of service, what kind of product, what results do they want to get through your product and service? Once you know these things, once you know what your people are looking for, you know what kind of people you're targeting. So you will know if it might be younger people, it might be older people, it might be women, it might be men, it might be all of them, but people who have this specific problem. So the age doesn't matter, and whether they're men or women doesn't matter, but it matters whether they're trying to solve this specific problem. They might be parents, they might all be parents, and trying to solve a problem for their children. So once you have identified your target audiences, what you do is you go get them. And the way you do that is you just need to think, where are they going to be? Where are they going to be, online, offline? How are you going to hook them, if you have to hook them, through word of mouth? Word of mouth is actually very easy, because once you have identified your ideal client, let's say we know that your ideal client is a mum who is trying to solve a problem for their children. Say you sell a lunch bag or a lunch box, and it's a lunch box that doesn't leak whatever you put in it. So obviously your target market is going to be parents, and it's going to be parents who cook fresh foods, and it's going to be parents who don't give their children sandwiches. So it's someone who likes organic, who likes doing food, cooking food in the house, who likes fresh food, fresh ingredients, likes cooking, obviously takes care of their children, is into health and well-being. They're probably gonna do yoga. They're probably gonna keep fit and healthy. They're probably not going to buy toxic cleaners or soaps. They're probably gonna go organic and non-animal tested and vegan in whatever they buy for their homes. This gives you an array of places where you're gonna find them. So you need to think about your client in terms of, what problems are you solving? What solution do they want? How fast they want the solution? And you're gonna know what type of person you are looking for. Once you know that, you're gonna be able to establish where they are. And once you know where they are, you're going to be able to identify how are you going to get them. So if it's people you can find around the football pitch, you're gonna think, you might want to think about putting adverts on the football pitch. If you know your people live on Instagram but never go on Facebook, it's useless to advertise on Facebook, or concentrate your efforts into posting on Facebook every day. But you might want to look at your Instagram grid and make it appealing for that kind of people, and so on and so forth. So this is basically a very straightforward process on how to identify and go get your ideal clients. If you have any questions, I am here. You can reach me through email at fran@underwingliverpool.com. You can go on the website, which is www.underwingliverpool.com. You can reach me on social media, on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook. It's at UnderwingLPL, which is short for Liverpool. You can comment on this video and let me know if there is anything you would like me to talk about, and whether these videos are of any use to you, or if you find them extremely boring, or if you've watched them and put something into place and changed something in your business and it actually worked, which I really hope it did. So I will see you next week for the next video, and I will not tell you what this is about, but I will tell you that a couple of weeks ago I put out a post asking all my clients and all my followers what would they like me to talk about, and the next video is going to be picked by one of those suggestions. I will see you next week. See you soon.